إله إلا الله إن للموت سكرات. And then as Aisha says, he looked up as though he saw something. And there are other ahadith that say Jibreel came to him, make your choice, O Muhammad. And he says, Allahumma al-Rafiq al-A'la. Aisha says, I quickly made dua, the recitations to rub on him, to say, oh Allah, cure him. He said, no, but salillaha al-Rafiq al-A'la. But ask Allah to give me the companionship of the ones most high. So then, in this situation, with the siwak having just been completed, and he having made his choice, and the hand trying to put water on its face, the hand fell. And Aisha radiallahu anha realized that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has passed away. And of the cry, the heartache, you can't imagine it. So then she sent for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that as the hand fell, the room became filled with fragrance. A smell, a perfume, a scent covered the room. And Salama says, I placed my hand on his chest. And because he's in fever, in sweating, and I lifted my hand. And Jum'ah came and Jum'ah went. I used to eat and make wudu, and the perfume and the scent of that perfume wouldn't go away. And this is the sunnah of the Zul Arsh al-Majid. When a righteous soul departs, the angels wrap it in a cloth perfumed with the most elegant of perfumes. And the perfume covered the room. And then Hafsa radiallahu anha sends for her father, Umar ibn al-Khattab. Aisha sends for her father, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, who is a kilometer and a half away. So the first one to enter the room after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Umar radiallahu anhu. Aisha says he knocked and asked permission because it's the house of Aisha. So he says, she says, I gave him permission, and look at the detail, and pulled my hijab over me. In the time of gham, yes, in the time of gham, why aren't you beating yourself for Aisha? Your Habiba has passed away, because this wasn't the teachings of the Rasul. They took the gham and the hum and the difficulties with Islam, with the call that Allah Rabbul Izzah had left for them. So she covered herself. And Umar came with another Sahabi, and Mughira ibn Shu'bah. So he came and looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, wa ghashiyah. And another, oh, so unconscious, so deeply unconscious. You are so unconscious. And then he stood up and tried to come out of the house. And Mughira said, Ya Umar, mata Rasulullah. He is not fainted, he has died. So he said, Kathabt, you are lying. You are lying. إِنَّكَ رَجُلٌ تَحُوشُكَ فِتْنَةٌ. You're a person that fitna has engulfed. The Prophet won't die. He has gone to his Lord and will return as Musa returned. And he will cut the right hands and the left legs of those munafiqs who say he died. He can't accept the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in his denial, he took out his sword. Whoever says the Prophet died, I will cut his neck off. Oh, the Prophet hasn't died. And he's shouting in the middle of the masjid, in the middle of this commotion, and the people have gathered around him. Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib, realizing the situation, says, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, is there anyone amidst you who has heard from, and it's a confusing time because they don't know what's happening. Umar, one of the greatest of the ummah, is shouting, he hasn't died. And the news is coming from the house, he has died. So Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib stood up, O people, is there anyone who has heard anything from the Prophet to the effect that I won't die? And they said no, and Umar said no. So then the Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib said, I make you witnesses over yourselves that Allah Rabbul Izzah, nor the Prophet has given any guarantee that he will live forever. As such, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has died. This was the first utterance that it came. And then Abu Bakr as-Siddiq came, radiyallahu anka ya Abu Bakr. He came from Sunh, and he entered the room of his daughter and the other wives who were sitting there covered. And then he went, and the Prophet is lying, salawat Rabbi wa salamuhu alayh, his face glowing bright. So he removed the cover from it, And then he رضي الله عنه leaned over and kissed the blessed forehead of the Rasul. And then looking up towards the heavens, he said, wa khalilaha, wa khalilaha, wa khalilaha. Oh my dear friend. Since childhood, they're friends. In the ghar, they were friends. He gave him his young daughter in marriage. He was the closest friend of the Prophet, the confidant of the Rasul, his best. Wa khalila, oh dear friend. And then he leant down and kissed him again. And then he said, wa safiya, oh you who are chosen, oh the chosen one. And then he kissed him again. And then this time leant over and kissed him. And he said, wa rasula, oh my Prophet, oh Rasul. And then he says, the death that Allah Rabbul Izzah prescribed upon you, you have tasted it. Allah won't let you taste this twice, death twice. And what the son of Khattab says is nothing. And then he radiyallahu anhu walked out of this room. And Umar is still shouting. So he said, ala rislika ya Umar. Sit, O Umar. Sit, O Umar. And Umar ibn al-Khattab is still shouting. So then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he radiyallahu anhu walked to the minbar in the front of the masjid, and then he gives his timeless words to the ummah. Whoever was worshipping Muhammad, understand that Muhammad has died. But for those of you who are worshipping Allah, understand Allah Rabbul Izzah is eternal and doesn't die. And then he read, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أفإن مات أو قتل انقلبتم على أعقابكم ومن ينقلب على عقبيه فلن يضر الله شيئا. Muhammad is not but the prophet. Prophets have come before him. Prophets have died before him. If he dies or is killed, will you forsake the deen? Will you turn back on your heels? And then Umar says, it's as though I had never heard the verse, and hearing it he fell. The truth sank. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away.